Hello, everybody. Sriram here. This is from Sri Learning. So we have a good smiling face in front of us from Melbourne. And that's Pridnesh, who cleared PMP recently. 13th of April, he cracked it. I think 13th of April is a lucky day. I found few more people as well cleared on the same day. So he cleared PMP recently. And we're just chatting about how things are happening, COVID, all the stuff. And he proudly said, Australia, we are free. Whereas in India, at present, in the month of April, we are so much tied to the too much of spread. Okay, all take good care. Weavers, thanks for watching this program. I know you come here to listen to some of the success tips. Sure, Pradhanesh is going to give some tips from Australia, telling that, hey, this can help you. That's what's going to happen here. So listen to this video, give your comments, what you like with his success story, right? Before we go to him, I just want to show his certificate. Because that's very important. Here it is. Pradhanesh Deshmukh cleared on 13th of April. It's valid for next 3 years. So after 3 years, he had to rewrite the exam. Deshmukh, are you ready to rewrite the exam? No, we have to collect some PDUs that makes you to renew the certificate another 3 years. This one time writing itself would have taken an amazing effort. So
it was a horrible. First of all, I will thank Sriram to you and Rahul. Because always motivating, always encouraging, and in your 4 hours lecture, not 4 hours, it always went up to five and a half hours. So at least 30% we get the motivational tips. And actually that was the most important thing. So study is there, but how to do that? What should be the mindset? That is very, very important. So I will again, thanks to you and Rahul for encouraging me.
And I want to thank you for trusting us and joining because Australia time zone is different. The classes are in different time. So you have to sit all the way late or drag yourself to sit there. It's not easy. So I really appreciate for that.
Yeah. But you have made fantastic infrastructure with your system. So most of the time I took the recording.
Very good.
Because very almost night here. Okay. And because I get a piece, just follow. And there's a matter of questions. You have so many follow-up sessions, no?
Right.
So, so that was not an issue. But I'm happy I joined Sri Learning and clear in first attempt. And that was my target.
Great. Congratulations for that great effort. Before we jump furthermore, give a little heads up on your experience or working domain, where you come from?
Yeah, frankly speaking, I'm a hybrid person. So I have more than 30 years experience.
30?
Yeah, 30.
Really.
I started working after I finished my 10th school.
Because you don't look
at the age of 15, I joined Tata Motors and I joined as an apprentice over there.
Okay.
And the telco training division, that's a Tata Motor training division, they develop us how to work and learn. And I'm proudly say whatever our teachers and even my managers and supervisors, they help me to support me. So because of whatever I am, because of Tata Motors. So I worked there for 25 years.
Wow.
Before I came to Australia in 2017.
25 years in one job. Man, proud of you.
1988 to 1991, I did my apprenticeship. And I started full-time working in 1992 April. Yeah, 20th April. And later on, let's learn something. I did part-time diploma. Okay. I finished my diploma in 1998. Then I got married. Then I had a daughter. Then wife said, oh, diploma, no market value. You are lucky. You are a part of Tata Group. But compared to market, so if you leave the company, no status, no value, no payment. Mm-hmm. So she took admission for me. She took me, she filled the forms. I was not ready. I said, but she insisted me, she support me. Mm-hmm. Then I did my part-time engineering. It's an evening college for the diploma degree, 6 to 9 college, and get the term granted and appear for the exam with the regular student with the same syllabus.
Wow, so that's nice.
Yeah, in 2007, I finished my engineering.
Which university?
Pune University.
Very good.
University of Pune. It's a regular studies with all regular students, same paper and same criteria, no exemptions.
Right.
Okay. Correct. Only they support you to grant your term, that's it.
That's right.
Yeah, then I got a good opportunity in management.
Mm-hmm.
And actually that gives me my interest toward the project management. Mm. And since 2009, I got managing the project, even with the software team management, software budgeting, project management, issue management. And 2012 to 17, I was actively doing project management with big electric vehicle development projects, hybrid vehicle, diesel and electric hybrid vehicle. Uh-huh. And that's from crash to delivery of the prototype, right? Uh-huh. Right from your stakeholder, you can say educate the stakeholder, because no one knows what is electric vehicle, what is hybrid. So educate them, search stakeholders overseas, then sign the agreements with them.
Wow.
Non-disclosure agreements. Okay. Then we purchase everything, go to the purchase, go to the HR, get the resources, get the software. We have to develop the software as well. Means, though I was with the predictive company, manufacturing company, our group was doing everything regarding that project. And 24/7, we're doing project. So there I got big confidence about the project. And I thanks to my management, my officers, they trust me at that time.
Nice.
And at that time, around 2014, I decided, oh, we should learn this. But no time, absolutely no time. But when I came here in 2017, then after a couple of years, initial settlement went off, then I decided I should do something. And actually in last pandemic, September, October was work from home or just 8 weeks lockdown, just searching on YouTube, internet, what to do. And I know we have to do the PDU, but I was thinking in December, I will go to India, then I will do the PDU, then I will give the exam after coming here. But that was not a chance.
Mm.
So, but luckily through the Udemy, I got the resources, and I maybe 10th April, 10th December, I got my PDUs and I applied for the PMP process, and it got approved in first shot.
Okay.
So, but I don't want to make a hurry and don't want to lose my December holidays, family enjoyment. So let's start in January. So I joined your course 23rd Jan. Till that, I have not studied anything. Just listen few videos regarding to get the PDU. That's it.
Okay.
And then I follow rigorously whatever you told in the classes. And actually, this PMP process means understanding yourself, means what, how you can deliver, what you like. Means you want to read, you want to listen, which is the best option for you. Initially, since the YouTube, free Wi-Fi, listening is good. But after listening, can you reproduce in the question paper? What you listen and what you means the, while in exam, we need the keywords.
Right.
To catch the keywords after listening, is it easy? Then I should, we should write and we should read it. And after in the time of the mock exam, I come to know reading is crucial. It's a game changer. Then how to start study? It's a big question. It was not easy. Means, I initially I talked to Rahul, then I ordered Rita Mulkai hard copy directly from their publication, US.
Very good.
But still not started. Oh, how such a big book, how can start? But then after your class started, then I have my friend Sachin, he was in Sydney, 1200 kilometers away. But we both started study, put the mobile on speakerphone, and we started with Pimbok, not Rita.
Okay.
Page number one, read loudly on speakerphone. After 2-3 pages, then he will start. After 2-3 pages again, every day 2 hours.
Very good.
Like that, initially start with 10 pages, 20 pages. Then we got a good pace. We finished whole Pimbok Agile Practice Guide.
Wow. And just with the phone speakers every day reading, you completed?
That's it. Means I will open the PDF on my screen. He will open the same PDF on his screen. And we just read whole Pimbok.
Nice. Amazing. Yeah,
that was the first step.
Okay.
And I think till that, almost your course come to close, end of the last 7th session, 8th session. Then I gave your first mock.
Right.
So I got 50. Okay. Actually, we read the Pimbok. We never understand it. Whatever, just read it. Just let hit the words in our mind. Means you should need that pace, no?
Right.
You should understand the ground. What is there? But due to industrial experience, and I can easily understand what is going on. What are the resources? What is the change management? And stakeholders. So it was not difficult for me, but how to convert that knowledge in marks was a big question. So slowly I finished reading. Then I talked to Rahul. He said, you do one thing. You have hard copy, either Pimbok or Rita. I said, yes, I have Rita hard copy. He said, you just highlight. Read and highlight. Highlight the keywords. And that was, that support me a lot. Because once you read completely, and if you highlight some, because writing notes for the maybe 600 page books is not easy. And you get tired, you get bored, whether it is going to ask or not. That was, your mind is not ready initially to prepare a notes. Because to take a notes, you have some gut feeling, understanding, this is important, I should write it. So that helps me. And then Rita test. And as you said, book exam, book. But I called you initially, what happened? So I give it, then I purchased PrepCast. Purchase PrepCast, give only 10 marks, 10 question tests. I got 7 correct. Oh, I know everything. But later on, for all the big mocks, I was just close to 50. So, and the score never changed. Whatever you read, your score as it is. The percentage around 50, whatever you get. And my exam dates are coming closer. I'm reading everywhere. Oh, you should have 70, at least 65, 68. So my clock is not moving ahead. So what to do? So first time I just postponed. I talked to you. And there are two aspects. One is your score. And another is your gut feeling. How much I prepared. At that time, I know I just read randomly. I have not did focused efforts. So at that time, I have a justification. I need to study more. I am not getting marks because I have not focused. I need to deep study is required.
Right.
Whatever the general knowledge you have, you can score easily 50%.
Right.
But if you really want to move ahead from this stage, you have to focus, focus, and focus. Otherwise, no. So I postponed it. So that, and later on, I started making notes, whatever the highlighted, whatever the question I missed. Means, you know, we had elimination technique in prep class. We can eliminate three options and last. So whatever option I eliminate, then that was the correct answer. Means what? Means here I honestly try to analyze. Means I got wrong because of my lack of knowledge, or that question was tricky, or I didn't understand the question at all. Means what was the root cause of wrong answer?
Right.
Then I come to know, say, if you correct, if you have the 100 answer correct, means 80 wrong. So I say, okay, I can, if I woke up and give exam, I can have 100 question correct. So rest of about rest of the 80, if I make another 40 correct, I am going to hit the exam. So out of that 80, how much questions I had made wrong because of not having a knowledge? Means while answering, if I have two options, I am not 100% confirmed this is this or this. Means there is a lack of knowledge. And few questions, may, out of 80, maybe 20, 25 questions, I read it wrongly.
Understand.
Means whatever the question I understand, my understanding while answering the question was wrong. When I read the answer from the prep cast, so then I come to know, perfect. With this question, this answer is perfect. I was wrong. Means while answering, my understanding towards the question was wrong. Means I, while reading the question, I am doing some mistake. Then what I started reading slowly. First, I did so many experiments. Read from the last only last sentence, but it's nothing going to happen. You have to read start to end slowly and understand one sentence and then move ahead. Then no need to read that question twice and then go to. And if question is small, means if you have very small answers, then you can read answer first. If the answers are very small, then read answer first, then it's okay. But in, when you go on the center screen or the in exam, you don't have the time. So the simple strategy of what I followed, read from start to end slowly and understand sentence to sentence. Though it's a four-line question, understand slowly. So no need to repeat. And if you understand it in first shot, then it's okay. It's okay.
That's
no
good.
Problem.
Nice.
And
nice.
I was struggling with the time management initially. And I gave almost 4 mocks. So always at least last 10 questions, I was struggling for the time. But it may be due to I practicing at home. Though we are serious, but it happens at home. But actual exam and the mock is mock. Your brain knows you are being mock. That is also one aspect. Yeah. That one thing. And second thing, what I understood, while answering agile question, I am making a lot of mistakes. And agile questions about the decision making. Understand? Because I am from the predictive project management cycle. And, you know, in India, the leader or manager, he has to take the whole ownership. Every decision he has to take.
Yeah.
And I have that mindset while answering the exam. I mean, most of the decisions are making by the team. What the product owner do? What is the, what are the responsibility of the team? So when I did that part with Agile Practice Guide, especially the last tables 4.1, 4.2, 5.1, A1.1, A1.2, right. And that give me better clarity. So I just took the printouts like this.
Oh,
your market.
Nice.
That was the key. And this was the game changer while answering. And this boost my scores. Because we can't take the printout of the whole PMBOK. But this was the my actually game changer.
So what's a pain number?
Pain points, you know, the pain point tables.
Yeah, yeah.
What to do if so PMBOK is giving you whole solution and we were not following it. So means, and these pain points, they are converting in a scenario.
Okay. Okay.
If you did this 20 questions straight away, uh-huh. Hit the target.
Uh-huh.
So nice. That helps me. And nice. In last 8 days, I did at least this 10 times. Even I wrote down this. And again, in my mocks, whatever the wrongs, the theory part, I took the notes. Mm-hmm. I have a whole book, around 200 pages notebook. I just writing. Even the 2 days prior to the exam, I was taking notes. Means because I know if I read it once, I may not remember it. But if I write it and highlight it, the keywords I'm going to remember. And that is going to help. Because always you used to tell in our session, just search keywords, focus on keywords.
Mm.
But if in question, you are finding keywords. Mm. But do you have the list of keywords with you? So you have to prepare a notes. Because, and that note making, because I was a little bit lazy guy. No one won, but now do and die conditions. Because second time, I decided not to postpone exam at any cost. Means it's not a fear of failure or something, but complete this sprint. We have decided for next 15 days, just complete this sprint. Let see the result, then we'll do the retrospective with the Sriram, and then we'll decide. Because I write text to you, if I postpone now, I don't have option, means how to prepare again.
Yeah.
In next 3 weeks, what to prepare? So whatever I prepare, let's go and hit the exam.
Perfect.
And let's see whatever happened. And one more thing, I was studying on the 14-inch screen laptop. And all mocks I did on that. So I was struggling. I can't read, enlarge the font, something. And you can't understand the question. But when I went to the center-based exam, it's a big screen. Even I can read without spec. And actually, that reduced my question reading time. easily you can read. It's a big font and easy. Means I insist everybody try to go to center. It's easy. Focus more.
Good idea.
So yeah, that was my study strategy. And last, as you said, always you said, take the leave last
few days.
8 days, at least 8 days, take a leave and focus. And that was really important. Really important.
Nice. Because,
yeah.
Nice to know. Great. Super. So happy to know that the whole system, what you said, it's doable if somebody really focus on it. Great. And you went to center-based exam. In the real exam, the time management was good in the sense of 180 questions.
Actually, I started good, no doubt. Means as per our understanding, we have up to 90 minutes. We can finish the part one, first 60 question. And I was having very good pace actually. And for first 60 question, no confusion, No second option. I had straight away hit. Out of four, this is the answer. Means I was pretty sure. I was moving very good. And I was just, I was not continuously looking for the clock. But I say, okay, 56th question. I am 70 minutes. Oh, very good. 52 questions, something. I mean, means target was in prep cast, they have given 72 minutes, 60 questions. So I just try to follow that. It's 72 minutes, 60 questions. Means altogether you have 10 minutes spare for the last.
Right.
And going good. But on 54th question, I got matched the pair. Okay. And not one, 54th matched the pair, 55th matched the pair, 56th matched the pair, 57th matched the pair. So then it took me 80 minutes for first 60 question. But okay. And same happened. Then I took a break. After 60 questions, I took a break. Just I outside wash at the chocolate bar, just move and come back. I consumed whole 10 minutes.
Okay.
Yeah. And the second part started. First 10, 20 question, no problem. Uh-huh. But after 90th question, all of a sudden, I can't read the question. No focus. Absolutely no focus. So what to do? Just I put the my spec down, close my eyes, deep breathing. Literally, I put Om Gan Ganpate Ma in my mind for 5 times. Then again started.
Okay.
And the second part was more tougher than part one. More tougher. And in second part also, 58, 59, 60 match the pairs. Okay. So, and when I finished part two, exactly 65 minutes were remaining.
Okay. Sharp.
Sharp. And I took that break. I come back in maybe 6 minutes, but I didn't start the exam. Next 3 minutes, I put my specs down, close my eyes. I meditate for another 3 minutes.
Very good.
Because this is my time. And then I started last session. And last session, it was a neck to neck because 65 minutes, you have to answer 60 questions. No more extra time. But I keep going. No confusion. Straight away answers. Just I saw, okay, 37 minutes left. 34 questions. 37 questions left. 34 minutes. Okay, I said, okay. Just focus like Dhoni. Let's see. Because now, no need to do the hurry. Just focus on the question by question. Go with your pace. Don't look at the clock. Because what was my theory? When doing the mocks, I understand. When I am making rush, I have to clear. Then I used to make a mistake. Because in prepcast, you have that chance. Means in last, always in last 20 questions, only 3 correct in my mocks exam. That was the my means understanding the mocks. This is also one of the strategy where you miss.
Right. Right.
So in, always I saw in my mocks last 20 question, only 3 or 4 correct. Means when you are making hurry, your mind is not reading your question properly. You are not understanding the scenario and you are randomly try to complete the test.
Right.
But right. On the real exam, on the 30th question in starting, I come to know I'm going to pass. That was my mindset. I am going to pass this exam. It is, I was that much confident. So go slowly. And what I decided, if I lose last 5 question, if I can't complete, don't worry. But give justification or justify your answers for the all the rest of the questions.
Perfect.
So, and I keep going. And again, 178th question matched the pair. And Only this time, I was so confused. See, I am seeing 2.5 minutes remaining. I can't understand that question. I try to move and go ahead, but it can't move. Means I try to left to right, right to left, but can't move. But just I skip that question. The only question I skip in exam, that was 178th. And then again, two questions that I answer. And just 10th minute, 10 second remaining for the exam, I submit.
God, man.
Yeah. So time management, I was struggling in a mock, but in a real exam, your brain know you're on center pitch. So it happened, it works. Actually, I enjoy the exam. I enjoy it. And first session, I understand I am going to pass. Don't worry. And whatever happened, let's see after the result. Great. And one more thing I did. I always keep myself positive. Fortunately, 4 or 5 days before the exam, I had one meditation video. On that, they said, if you are appearing for any exam, just close your eyes and meditate that whatever you are going to study, that is going to be asked. Just focus on yourself, and whatever you read for any topic, for any answer, just read that this is going to be asked in the exam. I have to answer this topic. Otherwise, what happened? You read so many things, but what do you read? Read only one page, no problem, but read it thoroughly. You can able to answer correctly. And that was my strategy. Wow. So in last 4 or 5 days, I just read what I understand.
Got you.
So many things I skip, but say no need to read everything.
Nice.
But what you read, just focus. You can able to reproduce what do you understand. That's it. That is the
wise advice, Pradnesh. In fact, the whole story, what I'm hearing from you, we can make it as a book and publish. Hey guys, follow this. I can see your 30 years of experience along with reading habits coming together. It's really, really, really good exposure what you're giving here. Great.
And I just forgot you to tell you, in my 40s, in 2013, I took admission for the MTech, Masters in Electronics Control System. And I did it in first shot. 2013-2015. And while working, means as I told you earlier, whatever I did while working. If you focus, and one more thing, that you have to spare your leaves. Normally, all we migrated outside India, we save our leaves to come back to India. That was a big target. But still, I said, okay, what is the most priority now? Now, the biggest priority is PMP.
Right.
Just focus on that.
Fantastic. I'm so impressed with your style of preparation and the confidence level, the positive way of looking things, meditating in the exam hall, right? Staying focused. I really like a lot of points from you. Right? Good advice and good information from you. How do you see PMP is valued in your job now? Going forward, you want to show this as a...
See, here, when you leave your country, the outsiders don't know what you are. Even they don't know the reality about the India.
Right.
Some people know if they have some experience with the Indian people. Otherwise, they don't know who are you. By reading your face, they can't understand what knowledge you have.
Perfect.
But this certification, give them confidence. Oh, yes, you have done PMP, means it is not only your local degree of your Indian university.
Right, international.
It is the world recognition certification.
Perfect.
And that is authentic certification.
Perfect.
They trust this certification. Otherwise, the second option, the outsider, the foreign countries, they respect their own qualification.
Right.
I just, I compare, now shall I do the MBA here or shall I do the PMP? I say PMP because we have experience and we can crack it. And we don't have time for the MBA.
Nice. Super, Pradinesh. I'm so impressed today. I'm so nice. I enjoyed listening to your whole success. I'm sure the viewers watching this video are going to take a lot of tips from you. I can see a lot of comments going to come for you in this video.
Oh, thank you very much.
Like your meditation, all those stuff there. Okay. First of all, thanks a lot for coming up here and speaking about your preparation, exam, mindset. I really like the mindset part very much, where it's about the mindset exam. This exam is not about a more technical. It's about mindset. Can I think as a leader in a pressurized situation? Can I see the same thing in a different angles? Not only from my angle, from other person's angle, right? Those things all you conveyed really well. Great, good. If you want to give any last tips for the people, anything you have for the students preparing?
See, if I can crack it, anybody can crack it. But just trust on yourself. Mm-hmm. See, when we start the exam preparation, we have a lot of options. But see deep inside within you at what type of person you are, means what the way of study will help you.
Great.
And it is not just mug up and go for the exam. Right. You have to understand the situation and respond spontaneously.
Rightly said.
And your first choice should be the perfect choice. Otherwise, if you confuse for any question, you're gone. So in all my 180 questions, hardly 8 or 9 questions I confuse. Otherwise, all straightforward answer. No confusion, just I tick and move ahead. Because I was surprised. I got above target in people and process. Means, over say 92% I got above target. No worries. I am extremely happy. So,
nice.
You the best wishes for the new aspirants. And great. Just focus on study. Hard work pays off.
Super.
And success comes like a butterfly. Yeah, it never comes. You can't find the butterfly, but it comes all of a sudden. Like that. Means, see, Saturday I was talking to you, what to do, buddy. And Tuesday, I'm extremely happy.
Right.
Means I was thinking, shall I postpone or not? Because due to COVID, there was an option of you can postpone without late charges.
Right.
Within 48 hours. And that was the big risk. So, and one more thing, just for the engineering exam, can you able to postpone by your own? No. Just fix the date and focus on that date. That's it.
Perfect. Great. Well said. Super. Once again, thanks a lot, Pradinesh, for coming up here. We'll give a congratulations to him for this wonderful success. And thanks a lot for giving such a wonderful information about the preparation exam. Right, that's great. Okay, good wishes to viewers who are watching this video. I know a lot of people are watching this for some tips. I'm sure you got a lot from here. Leave your comments. What do you like with his way of preparation? And give your congratulations to him. Thanks a lot, Pradinesh. And thanks a lot, all the viewers. Okay. Keep rocking more.
Thanks, Sriram. I will again say, Jai Sriram. Thanks. You are a really good teacher, good leader, good motivator. I really enjoyed the journey. Thank you very much. Yeah. I wish you the big success for the Sri Lankan as well. Thank you.
Sure, I appreciate it. Yeah. Thank you.